This video is designed to explore the natural fusion of all the spiritual aspects that define our humanity and their importance for the future. Musically and culturally, the video draws together two world-shaping celebrations. It begins with the celebration of the liberation of Palmyra in Syria from the terrorism of ISIS in May 2016, and it closes with the celebration of the still unfolding Belt and Road Initiative in China towards universal economic development and prosperity in the world. What sets us, humanity, apart from all other forms of life on the earth is that we excel in the intangibles, which one might call spiritual. These are aspects that one cannot weigh or measure or store up in portfolios for rainy days. They are the little things that define us, which together are so big that civilization would collapse without them, like the factor of love, for example. The video is designed to draw spiritual aspects together from widely dispersed backgrounds and ages into a closely knit fusion. For the aspect from the most distant time, a universally known work was chosen that is attributed to Christ Jesus, the master and originator of Christianity, who is also an honored prophet in Islam. The chosen work is generally known as the Lord's Prayer. Moving forward in time by 18 centuries, the renowned American spiritual leader and healer, Mary Baker Eddy, working in New Hampshire in the USA, added to the historic prayer an advanced scientific dimension, which she interspersed into the historic texts. This too is included in the video. The resulting 16 stanzas, drawn from the historic Lord's Prayer, are further intertwined in this video with a fusion of poetry and art. Both of these were first published in 1893 as a controversial poem by Mary Baker Eddy, produced in 16 parts, which she had extensively illustrated by the renowned artist of her time, James F. Gilman. Going forward still further in time to the more recent stage, I inserted one of my own poems into the fusion, illustrated with my own photography. The poem, in turn, furnishes a link to my 14 novels on spiritual freedom, which thereby adds these two into the resulting grand fusion. In order to give the flow of the fusion project an orientation, I have chosen the four-part orientation that Mary Baker Eddy had pioneered back in the late 1800s to orient her own extensive work. She defined her orientation in terms of four rivers flowing northward, eastward, southward, and westward, according to the orientation of the sun in the sky over the span of a day. These four orientations in the video are presented with background music chosen from the Palmyra concept in 2016 and from the gala closing performance of the historic Belt and Road Forum held in Beijing in China a year later. The linkage was chosen to honor both Russia's and China's long cultural history. The new paradigms that both countries are laying before the world, actively aiming for real peace, heartfelt humanity, tall cultural optimism, and effective economic development, may yet enable our widely diverse modern society to join hands in love for our common humanity, to meet the Ice Age challenge that already looms before us as the greatest challenge in the entire history of humanity, second to none. In this arena, the insignificant-seeming spiritual intangibles do actually shape our destiny, and perhaps more so than we yet realize. So let's begin the spiritual fusion exploration. Fast circling on from zone to zone, bright, blessed afar, o'er the grim night of chaos shone one lone brave star. Our Father, which art in heaven, seeds wind blown, carriers of a secret still unknown, poems in the words of nature, sentinels of an intelligence yet unseen, prophets of the enduring, apostles in an endless landscape. Seeds, windblown, poems in the words of nature, sentinels of an intelligence yet unseen. In tender mercy, spirits bed, a loyal ray, to rouse the living, wake the dead, and point the way. Our Father, Mother God, all harmonious, harvest is seed time, thoughts ripening, carried as by a great wind, carriers of secrets to unfold, thought winged with purpose, a force waiting, silent, patiently waiting for the moment. Harvest is seed time, thoughts ripening, carried as by a great wind, carriers of secrets to unfold. The Christ idea, God anoints, of truth and life, the way in science he appoints that stills all strife. Hallowed be thy name. Thoughts to awaken, roused by the moist warmth in spring, cascades of colors, colors of life, bright yellows, bursts of silver white, thoughts becoming creations, monuments of genius, builders of worlds. Cascades of colors, colors of life, bright yellows, bursts of silver white, thoughts becoming creations. What the beloved knew and taught, science repeats, through understanding dearly thought, with fierce heartbeats. Adorable one. Thus Christ, eternal and divine, to celebrate, as truth demands, this living vine ye demonstrate. Thy kingdom come. Who owns the seeds? Do we? Who can fathom their wonder? Life flows from them in great rivers, rivers trailing into oceans. In them we are alone. Each one is alone. Each thought is sovereign. Beauty is its song. Who owns the seeds? Do we? Life flows from them in great rivers, rivers trailing into oceans. For heaven's Christus, earthly Eves, by Adam bid, make merriment on Christmas Eves, or babe and crib. Thy kingdom is come, thou art ever present. Thoughts are seeds becoming ideas, a life in discovering, a life in listening, a life in being touched by love, a life in loving, a life in listening, a life in being touched by love, a life in loving. Yet wherefore singleize the birth of him there born? What can rehearse the glorious birth of this high morn? Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Like seeds, thoughts fall to the ground, potentials are lost, hard grounds kill the precious. But we are men. Hard ground becomes tilled, watered. The precious is nurtured in loving. Hard grounds kill the precious. But we are men. Hard ground becomes tilled, watered. Christ was not crucified, that doom was Jesus' part, for Sharon's rose must bud and bloom in human heart. God was manifest in the flesh. Enable us to know, as in heaven so on earth, God is omnipotent, supreme. forever present, boundless, free. Christ comes in gloom and aye, with grace towards you and me, for health makes room. Give us this day our daily bread. Love for one another, the human spring. Mankind is afloat in the sea that is love. Seeds germinate, become plants. Roots break the ground. Love lifts the barriers patiently, silently waiting, reaching for the sky. Roots break the ground. Love lifts the barriers, patiently, silently waiting, reaching for the sky. Thus olden face, pale star, now blends in seven-hued white, life without birth and without end, emitting light. Give us grace for today. Feed the famished affections. Thoughts are the universe unfolding, landscapes of brilliance, ideas of power, substance for enriching one another, substance of the forever maturing. Thoughts bearing new seeds within, seeds for splendors beyond dreams. Landscapes of brilliance, ideas of power, substance for enriching one another, substance of the forever maturing. The way, the truth, the life, His word, are here and now. Christ's silent healing, heaven heard, crowns the pale brow. And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Each harvest is seed time. A seed becomes a plant bearing new seeds. A thought unfolding bears up civilization. A spark in the heart bears the fire of life. New worlds are created in the fire of passion. We are the bearers of a fire that is light. A thought unfolding bears up civilization. A spark in the heart bears the fire of life. New worlds are created in the fire of passion. For Christian Science brings to view the great I Am, omniscient power, gleaming through mind, mother, man. And love is reflected in love. As in blessed Palestina's hour, so in our age, 'tis the same hand unfolds his power and writes the page. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Builders of worlds are we, new worlds which have never been, precious with riches grander than our own. Nature is love reflected in loving. Love paints with the colors of its endless spring. Love paints us all, but who owns the seed? Precious with riches grander than our own. Nature is love reflected in loving. Love paints with the colors of its endless spring. Today, as oft, away from sin, Christ summons thee. Truth pleads tonight, just take me in, no mass for me. And God leadeth us not into temptation, but delivers us from sin, disease, and death. Who owns the cradle for the seed? Name it intelligence, name it the universe. Thoughts are seeds from an infinite fountain, monuments of grandeur of good. Fields of flowers dancing in the sunshine. All nature whispers this to us. Thoughts are seeds from an infinite fountain, monuments of grandeur of good. Fields of flowers dancing in the sunshine. No plight, no broken wing, no moan, truth fain can dim. Eternal swells Christ's music tone in heaven's hymn. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. The melody of nature, what a song, whispers of a splendor grander than the heavens. Like seeds are we whisper too, seeds bearing gifts for the world, gifts wrapped up in sunshine. Gems are we, unfolding a majestic song. Whispers of a splendor grander than the heavens. Like seeds are we whisper too, seeds bearing gifts for the world. And he that overcometh and keepeth my work unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations, and I will give him the morning star. Christ Jesus. For God is infinite, all power, all life, truth, love, over all and all. Listen to the song, listen to the heart, listen to the silence where strands of love unfold. Listen to the symphony of our humanity. In this symphony we are one, one with the universe itself. Listen to the song, listen to the heart, listen to the silence where strands of love unfold. Listen to the symphony of our humanity. In this symphony we are one, one with the universe itself.